You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained today, the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host, Skyrim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that gives you a glimpse of a country's diversity. Celebrating the essence of tribal crafts, art and culture, the 15-day-long tribal festival or Adi Mahotsav was organized in the capital city, New Delhi. Tribes from different states and union territories of the country congregated under one platform to showcase tribal crafts and arts to visitors. Take a look.
The tribal art and craft of India is simple and ethnic, yet colorful and vibrant, reflecting the country's rich cultural heritage. In a bid to provide a platform where the tribal artisans can both showcase as well as sell their artworks, Adi Mahotsav is organized every year in New Delhi. This year, the fair saw a participation of around 1,000 artists from various states of the country, forming a mini India at one place.
आदि महोत्सव में बेसिकली हमारा जो ट्राइबल क्राफ्ट कल्चर क्यूजीन को हम प्रमोट कर रहे हैं, तो इसमें जो आदि महोत्सव में अब अगर आप देखेंगे तो यहाँ पे अराउंड 1000 आर्टिस्ट आर्टिसंस एंड ट्राइबल कुक्स आए हुए हैं, जो कि अराउंड 27 स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज से हैं, और अलग अलग तरह के जो उनके फॉरेस्ट प्रोड्यूस होते हैं, जो हैंडीक्राफ्ट एंड हैंडलूम के प्रोडक्ट्स होते हैं और ट्राइबल क्यूजीन जो होते हैं वो उनको डिस्प्ले कर रहे हैं और सेल कर रहे हैं। ये बहुत हेल्प कर रहे हैं और ये एक्चुअली डायरेक्टली ट्राइबल्स को हेल्प कर रहे हैं। जो अभी तक हमने लास्ट संडे को जो इनका जो इन आदिवासियों ने जो यहाँ पे अपने प्रोडक्ट सेल कर रहे थे वो हाईएस्ट था, जो एक दिन में उन्होंने 60 लाख का अराउंड प्रोडक्ट्स उन्होंने एक दिन में संडे को सेल किया था। तो इट इज़ वेरी गुड, उनको काफ़ी अच्छा फ़ायदा मिल रहा है और डायरेक्ट फ़ायदा उनको मिल रहा है। इसमें कोई मिडिल मैन और कोई इन्वॉल्व नहीं है। जो हम उनको सारे फैसिलिटीज़ प्रोवाइड करते हैं, जैसे स्टॉल्स उनको मुफ्त में मिल रही है, उनको कुछ देना नहीं पड़ रहा है।
Organized by the Union Ministry of Tribal Affairs along with the Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India, TRIFED, this year the Grand Festival saw a footfall of 8,000 to 10,000 visitors on a daily basis. Around 200 stalls were set up at the festival, selling a wide variety of items like handicrafts, handlooms, paintings, shawls, artworks, showpieces and more. While the display of tribal jewelry from different states reflected the effervescent tribal beauty and ethnicity, the varieties of bamboo crafts and organic food products showcased the rich and healthy tribal lifestyle.
For the first time we are came here, and it was such a beautiful experience. You know, we have got a lot of feedbacks, not just the sale. Apart from sale, we have a lot of feedbacks. We interact with a lot of customers. And there are designers who came here, and there are people who are working in this industry came here. They have given a lot of suggestions. We have valued all those suggestions, and I think this was a very fantastic experience for us. This is made by a tribals of Idukki district. It's called sun weaving. It's made out of reed bamboo, and this is a bamboo lampshade. This is a common species, you know, found in almost everywhere in Kerala.
As no festivity or event in India is complete without food, the fair also set up a food court named Adi Vyanjan, where various lip-smacking dishes were available on a platter. The food court had different stalls set up where food items of almost all the states and union territories of the country were available. Visitors were seen relishing different cuisines and enjoying the diverse food culture of the country.
हमने जम्मू एंड कश्मीर के स्टॉल से रिश्ता, गुस्ताबा, इनकी सारी जो डिशेज हैं, एक एक डिश, एक बाजवान आता है जिसमें सारी डिशेज होती हैं, तो वो खाया।
This year's highlight, however, were the cultural performances that were organized during the evening for visitors to get a glance into the beautiful tribal music and dance of various states and union territories of the country. To grace the occasion, Indian classical vocalist and Padma Shri awardee Ustad Rashid Khan mesmerized the audiences with the melodious performance. Such festivals are not only paving a path of development for tribal communities, but in a way enabling the artifacts made by them to reach customers directly and thereby boosting business at the same time. The Adi Mahotsav is one of government's continuous efforts to take tribal commerce to the next level and familiarize urban citizens with the tribal and cultural roots.
Best out with myriad faiths, castes, creeds and religions, India has incredibly kept its unity alive. The 718 Urs of Hazrat Khwaja Nizamuddin commemorated in the capital city New Delhi was one such example that very well showcased the religious diversity of India. Devotees coming from different religions paid a visit to the shrine, thus putting forward a picture of united and undivided India.
The 718th Urs of Hazrat Khwaja Nizamuddin was commemorated with much fervor in the capital city, New Delhi. Thousands of visitors came to visit the shrine, which is at the center of the city's multicultural ethos, indiscriminative of any religion.
और साल सारी गद्दियाँ दरबार से जितनी भी हिंदुस्तान में गद्दियाँ हैं सारी गद्दियों के सज्जादे अजमेर शरीफ के सज्जादे लोग आए और हमारे के सज्जादे थे सारे और बहुत से जायरीन आए पाकिस्तान से भी 43 लोग आए पाकिस्तान से दरगाह शरीफ में ज़ारत के लिए चादर पाकिस्तान से भी आई यहाँ पे हिंदू मुस्लिम सिख ईसाई हर धर्म के लिए दुआ होती है देश के लिए भी दुआ एकता भाईचारा प्यार मोहब्बत अता फरमाए सरकार ने हमें मिलाई सब
It is a belief among the disciples that the demise of Sufi saints is not mourned, rather it is celebrated as their union with God. So, to celebrate the occasion, fakirs and kawals from across the country attended the Urs and enthralled the audience with their kawali performances. It is said that Nizamuddin, the patron saint of Delhi, had willed that there should be Sama musical festivities at his funeral procession. That tradition has continued for over 700 years now.
यहाँ पर ये सूफियाए इकराम तशरीफ लाए और इन्होंने यहाँ से मोहब्बत का पैगाम पूरी दुनिया को दिया। उन्होंने जिस रूहानियत के मिशन को शुरू किया उस मिशन को हज़रत निज़ामुद्दीन औलिया महबूब इलाही ने मुकम्मल किया और उसको फ़रोग दी सूफीज़्म रूहानियत का मतलब है भाईचारा मोहब्बत इत्तेफाक सुलूक और सबको मोहब्बत से मिलना किसी को छोटा बड़ा न समझना किसी को बरतर और अबतर ना समझना सब गोरे को काले को गोरे पे कोई अहमियत नहीं है जो मैसेज रिसालत माँ बाकी दो जहाँ ताजदार मदीना वो मोहम्मद रसूलुल्लाह सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम ने दिया था
As a holy sacrament, langar was also organized at the darga that serves meals as per the liking of devotees who belong to different cultures and religions, thus making sure everyone can get the blessings of the saint without any discrimination. Message of love, peace and compassion towards each other continues to bring people to the shrine.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A man gifted a house tile as a miniature of the iconic Taj Mahal monument to his wife, drawing the attention on social media. Anand Prakash Choksi, an educationalist based out of a small town in central Madhya Pradesh state, did not want to settle for anything less than one of the biggest symbols of love to proclaim his affection for his wife.
वो मेरे साथ हर बात में खुश है, सपोर्ट करती है। उनकी एक ही डिमांड थी कि एक इसमें मेडिटेशन करने के लिए ध्यान का कक्ष अच्छा बने। तो मैंने भी प्रायोरिटी बेसिस पर सबसे अच्छी लोकेशन में मेडिटेशन रूम बनाया और चूंकि ये डोम साइज का है तो जो लोग ध्यान करते हैं मेडिटेशन करते हैं उनके लिए एक आइडियल प्लेस है शांति से बैठने के लिए।
The four bedroom house also features a library and a special meditation room built specifically on the request of Choksi's wife. The carving sculptors were called from West Bengal and artisans from Indore and Western Surat city. The cost of house is about $260,000. Choksi's mini Taj Mahal is also open to visitors, but only during school hours. Although the design of the house is heavily inspired by Taj Mahal on the outside, Choksi has built the interiors to fit to a modern lifestyle. Devotees offered prayers and took holy dips in Indus River in India's northern Ladakh region as they marked the Sindhu Pushkaram festival, a festival dedicated to the river. Devotees perform rituals to worship the river, that is an important aspect of the life of the people.
हम बहुत अच्छा हैं, बहुत ठंडी भी हैं, और यहाँ का जगह इतना अच्छा है कि यहाँ रहने के लिए मन कर रहा है, बहुत अच्छा है यहाँ.
The festival is celebrated as per zodiac sign of the 12 major rivers in the country. One of the longest rivers of Asia, the Indus River flows through Ladakh region and also passes through Gilgit-Baltistan region in Pakistan. Fans of Bollywood star Salman Khan said that they love the Punjabi look and flavor to his new role in Bollywood gangster action drama Antim, The Final Truth. Released last week across the theaters in India, it is one of the biggest releases from Bollywood in post-coronavirus period.
Obviously, Salman ka action mujhe bahut acha laga aur pehli baar wo pagdi mein aaye the to wo aur bhi acha laga, wo bahut cute lag rahe the, to yes, mujhe almost sab kuch hi acha laga and Ayush ki acting bhi is baar bahut achhi thi.
Apart from Khan, the movie also stars Ayush Sharma and Mahima Makwana in leading roles. Directed by filmmaker Mahesh Manjrekar and produced by Khan, the film is a remake of 2018 Marathi film Mulchi Pattern, where Khan will be seen playing the role of a cop who fights a gangster played by Sharma.
India is home to a number of different religious communities and ethnic groups that have been residing in this country from hundreds of years from now. Example of this harmonious coexistence could be found in almost all the places in India. One such example was recently seen in Gorakhpur city of Uttar Pradesh, where an imambara has been serving as a symbol of religious unity for years.
It's been said that the happiness of mankind lies in the unity and harmony of human race. Several examples of such happy and harmonious existence of mankind could be found in different nooks and corners of the country. A similar example is that of an imambara in Gorakhpur city of Uttar Pradesh, which is revered by all citizens regardless of the caste and religion.
Imambara ka jab naam lete hain to logon ke dimag mein aata hai ki ye musalmanon ki koi cheez hai. लेकिन अच्छी बात यह है कि गोरखपुर का जो इमामबाड़ा है, ये सिर्फ मुसलमानों के लिए नहीं, ये यहाँ के इवन जो हिंदूज हैं या और भी धर्म के मानने वाले लोग हैं, सबके दिलों में इसके पीछे एक आस्था है और आस्था से वो जुड़े हुए हैं इमामबाड़े से, क्योंकि इमामबाड़े में देखा जाए तो एक सोने और चांदी की भव्य ताजिया भी रखी हुई है जो कि 300 बरस पुरानी है, उसी ज़माने की है जब ये निर्माण हुआ था, और उस वक्त से आज तक भी देखा जाए तो यहाँ के जो स्थानीय लोग हैं गोरखपुर और उसके आसपास के लोग, उनको मैंने देखा है कि उनकी एक इमामबाड़े से आस्था है, उस ताजिए से आस्था है, तो उसका बहुत महत्व है इस पूरे।
Legend goes that in the year 1717, Roshan Ali Shah used to do his prayers at this place. A Nawab from the then Awadh region named Asifuddaulah got impressed by his divinity and decided to construct this Imambara for him. Since then, people of different faiths come here to pray. They tie a holy knot and a bangle with it for fulfillment of wishes.
हम लोग यहाँ पे आते हैं, पूजा पाठ करते हैं और सभी धर्म के लोग आते हैं, जिसकी जो आस्था रहती है वो अपने आप से पूजा करता है। हिंदू धर्म के लोग भी आते हैं, मुस्लिम धर्म के लोग भी आते हैं, सभी धर्मों के लोग आते हैं। ऐसे जो है मुस्लिम लोग होते हैं वो गोरखनाथ मंदिर में जाते हैं, तो यहाँ पे गोरखपुर में मतलब ये पूजा पाठ करने में कहीं किसी भी धर्म का भेदभाव नहीं रहता, सभी लोग अपने अपनी आस्था के अनुसार पूजा पाठ करते हैं।
The solidarity among the different religious communities has remained a hallmark of India's unity since time immemorial.
And now we will introduce you to Kalaripayattu, one of the oldest traditional Indian martial arts, form originated in the southern state of Kerala, which is still being practiced in some parts of the state.
Land of great warriors and mightiest men on earth, Indian martial arts are not only good combat exercises but are also a great way of maintaining physical as well as mental well-being. One such regional martial art form is that of Kalaripayattu, which is said to have been originated in India's southern state of Kerala.
Kalaripayattu is a very ancient wisdom of India as well as Kerala. It helps to improve the general health in physical as well as mental level. It has an element of sacred worship of Lord Parashurama.
Considered to be one of the oldest martial art forms in the country, Kalaripayattu involves training with weapons and freestyle fighting. Its training begins with a huge baton which is nearly 6 feet long. In the later course of training, the trainees gradually move to smaller weapons like muchan, a small staff, or an ota, a curved stick. The art form is still practiced in regions of Kerala and Tamil Nadu state and is also popularly used in filming stunt scenes in Bollywood movies.
The Kalarisangam is full functional. The people around this Kalarisangam, including youngsters and children, are coming here and practicing Kalaripayattu. Hope this will bring this sacred land to a higher purpose.
The martial arts form also includes power yoga and massaging routines.
At last, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section of World in Focus. Kikkoman, a leading soy sauce company based in Japan, has acquired the majority of the global market. Kikkoman sells Japan's unique soy sauce as an all-purpose seasoning, not a single tasting seasoning. In 1957, Kikkoman entered the US market and is currently operating in more than 100 locations around the world.
We start selling our soy sauce not as a condiment for Japanese food, but we try to sell our product as all-purpose seasoning. and we acquire a marketing catchphrase, delicious on meat. And actually, it's good on meat. We marinate the piece of meat with Kekkoman soy sauce and grill right in front of the people and let them eat. We call it in-store demonstration. We did it in many supermarket stores, and that was successful.
Kekkoman advertised soy sauce in all-purpose seasoning in a TV commercial aimed at attracting viewers and emphasized the strategy of promoting soy sauce in local areas for consumers to actually know the taste of soy sauce. The company's motive is to make good quality soy sauce which is consumed by many people all across the world. A large menorah fitted with light bulbs stood in the middle of Israel's pavilion at Dubai's Expo 2020 during the celebration of the Jewish Festival of Lights, also known as Hanukkah.
Hanukkah is a festival of the light, where each one of us is asked to look for his own internal light and to share it with the other. But not only, it's our duty to go and look at the light of the other. Why? Because together, once all the lights are shining together, we are much more powerful, much more significant, and it has much more meaning.
Jews and Emirates were among the many visitors of the event, which included a musical performance and dance. It was the first time for a number of visitors to celebrate Hanukkah outside of Israel, and it represented a candle in the night to have a Jewish holiday marked in the Arab world. Hanukkah is celebrated by Jewish people around the world for 8 nights with nightly menorah lighting and special prayers. The festival is one of the most beloved Jewish holidays. The geothermal electric power plant at Oyasu region in Akita Prefecture has been set up for operation by Itimitsu Kosan, a company known for specializing in gas station operation.
Itimitsu Kosan が地熱に取り組んだのは1970年代に遡りまして、まあ、ご案内のように石油の、まあ、危機が70年にございましたけれども、まあ、その後ですね、出光は当然エネルギー会社でございますので、エネルギーの安定供給ということで、まあ、会社としては石油中心だったんですけれども、70年代から石炭、それからウラン、そして地熱開発に取り組んだというのが経緯でございます。地熱発電というのは、地球がボイラーと考えていただければよいかと思います。で、我々井戸を掘りまして、まあ、それが、大体1500メーターか3000メーターほど井戸を掘りまして、その井戸の中からですね、地熱の流体、まあ、水蒸気、熱水が出てきますが、それを分離して、蒸気をタービンに送って発電するという仕組みでございますので、ご案内のように日本というのは火山国でして、非常に多くの地熱の不存量ポテンシャルがあります。まあ、そういう意味で、まあ、純国産のエネルギーだというところが一つの特徴でございますし、また地熱というのは、まあ、CO2 の排出量が非常に少なくて、まあ、環境負荷が小さいということで、非常にクリーンなエネルギーということがまた一つの特徴ですね。再生可能エネルギーの一つですけども、自然環境の影響を受けて変動しますけども、地熱というのは非常に安定的なベースロード電源として見なされておりまして、安定的な地域活用電源だというふうに思っています。海外での調査もやりたいということで、まだスタディの段階ですけど取り組み始めたところです。ポテンシャルの高いアメリカであったり、インドネシア、フィリピンというところをですね、まあ、一つのターゲットとして考えておりますけども、まあ、各国それぞれ環境政策とか政治的なものもございますので、まあ、そういうそのいろいろな要因を考慮した上で、次のステップに行ければいいなというふうに考えています。
In Japan, Idemitsu operates gas station and also develops geothermal energy.
Searching for geothermal energy stored in deep underground consumes a lot of time and money. But Edemitsu Kosan continuously tries to develop clean energy. Dogs reigned over the waves in the Brazilian coastal city of Natal during the Surf Dog Festival.
O Bono está comigo desde que ele tinha 40 dias, era uma bolinha assim de pelo. E a ideia era comprar uma prancha de stand-up para começar a remar, começar a fazer aquela atividade do stand-up, que por sinal é muito boa, eu sou educador físico. Cara, o Bono subiu na prancha e foi impressionante. Primeira vez que ele subiu, rabo começou a abanar e começou a latir. Então a felicidade dele em cima da prancha começou a meio que a chamar a atenção do pessoal. Nossa, o cachorro é amarradão em cima da prancha.
During the competition, dogs served next to the owners on paddle boards, while beginners were provided with life vests to ensure safety in the water. First place winners were Parafina and her owner Augusto Caesar. The pair had previously won silver and bronze medals at the World Championships.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host, Skyrim Zimik, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.